Hey Harpers, I'm Tiffany Schaefer from TiffanyHarpAndSong.com. Welcome to Let's Talk Harp, where we talk about all things harp related. Today we're going to talk about sets, what are sets, how to put sets together, especially since we have learned three tunes that go in a set this summer. I'm going to show you how I would put those together smoothly and talk a little bit about sets in general. So what do we mean by sets? You might know them as a medley, so playing two or three or four tunes in a row, smoothly transitioning them without any breaks. So what kind of tune should be in a set? Now we're talking really about the traditional Celtic repertoire. So the general consensus that I've seen is that traditionally in Irish sets, you'll have like two or three or four of the same tune type, a few reels, a few hornpipes, or a few jigs in a row, whereas in Scottish music, you'll hear a lot more different tune types being strung together, like the set we've learned this summer. A common one is a march followed by a strathspey followed by a reel, or a jig in a couple of reels, or a slow air and a strathspey and a reel. Not that you have to end every set with a reel, but reels are one of the more faster dances that you'll play, and you generally always want to save the fastest tune for the last. They don't always have to be fast tunes. Try a couple of slow ones, or a slower one into a faster one. One of the best things about folk music is, depending on what setting you're playing in, you can do whatever sounds good to you. So what about keys? In our set this summer, we saw that there are ways to have several different tunes in different keys without even changing the levers. We did that by using a mode. We used Mixolydian, a major key, and a minor key that all had the same key signature of two sharps. Comment question, let me know in the comments below if you would like a video just exploring some modes and what modes mean. That is something I also plan to go over a little bit in my Back to Basics Zoom harp course. You can also let me know if you want to hear more about that. That's coming probably this fall. Of course, you can also play tunes in a set that are in the same key. You can also play tunes that are in completely different keys and just change levers in between. And we're gonna go over some examples now and talk about different ways you can do that. So first let's start with the MSR, or the March Strathspey Reel, that we learned this summer. The Athol Highlanders into Stirling Castle into the Ailes Deer, and talk about how we could smoothly transition from one tune into the other. When you're doing this, you might have to leave out a note on the end of one tune to go into the next one. Some of them work very well and you can just play one right after the other and it sounds seamless. But some you might have to tweak a little bit. So we're in the key of two sharps. Normally this would be D, but we're playing as if we're in A. We're just leaving that G that's normally in A major. We're leaving that G down. That means we're in a Mixolydian mode. So the way I have you ending Athol Highlanders in the sheet music is a big A chord at the end, ending with that low A. And then I would just go straight into Stirling Castle. But another thing you might do to keep your bass from getting a little muddy, since we're changing to a new key, we're not just gonna let it ring out and end there, you might wanna end Athol Highlanders a little bit higher. Maybe just stay on that middle A there before you go straight into Stirling Castle. So that sounds something like this. And you just go straight into it. We don't really have to leave out any notes. We don't have to do anything super fancy. It'll just go. I've turned my camera down a little bit so you can hopefully see my left hand and right hand a little better. So let's talk about how to transition from Stirling Castle to the Ailes Deer. So Stirling Castle ends like this. So on that definite D chord, that's where it ends, and it ends on actually the D note as well, the melody does. So we've got to figure out how to get from this to this, to that F sharp where the Ailes Deer starts, and that B minor chord. So in order to do this without changing anything, we'd probably have to add an extra beat in there. It would sound something like this. awkward to me. It kind of adds an extra count in there that we don't really need. So what I would do is change this slightly. Instead of ending on a D and a D bringing that bright D chord back in, let's change the definite ending chord to a B minor. We're gonna end Stirling Castle on this F sharp. So just like this. And then we'll start right in to the next tune. So here it is in context, just so you can hear it. Have to slow down or anything. Some other tunes I've taught on my channel that I would suggest putting together. By the way, I'm going to link in the description my Irish Tune Tutor playlist and my Scottish Tune Tutor playlist so you can easily find all of these. Are Road to Lisdenvarna and the Morrison Jig. I play those together on my album Tara's Halls, and they're pretty easy to flow one right into the other. Here's how Road to Lisdenvarna ends. If I were going right back into it, it would sound like that. The beginning of Morrison Jig starts like this. So what I'm taking is the end of Lisdenvarna, that D, and then go straight into the Morrison's Jig. One more time, just so you can hear it in context. Etc. So what are you going to do if a couple of your tunes require actual key changes, but they do sound nice one right after the other, and you have to change your levers in between the piece? So there are a couple ways you can try and do this creatively without breaking things up. Sometimes you can get away with leaving one or two levers down if you don't play them in your new key. For example, I'm going to show you a couple of tunes now, one in E minor into B minor, and I need to bring up all my C's, but I never play this bottom C. So I'm just going to leave it down. Also in this tune, I'm going to show you I need to play one C sharp accidental. So that's already going to be up for me. And I don't need it until I get to that particular spot in the tune. So I just will leave it up throughout the whole tune. So this is another one I'm going to be playing The Ale Is Dear into. And it's a jig by Mary McMaster called The Red Jacket. And I play it in E minor, sort of goes into E Dorian with the C sharp in here, but the ending of it sounds like this. And then it goes straight back into the A part, which I don't want to do. I want to run straight into the A with dear. So I've changed it around a little bit. Instead of ending it up way up here on this G, like that, so what I'm doing here is this C is already up. This lower C I don't need. All I need to flip is this C, this one, and this one. And I'm giving myself plenty of time to do that within my arrangement because my left hand here is very minimal, so I can change levers here. Done. I already have all of the ones I need up. So you can think about playing tunes that are in keys not too far off from each other, like from going from two sharps to three sharps. That way you only have to change one note across your harp, rather than going from one sharp to three sharps. That would be a lot harder. And again, you can medley a couple of slow tunes together or a couple of easier tunes. Let's try something like I've also taught on my channel, Brian Brew's March, into another tune in the same key. If we're ending Brian Brew's why not try going into something like Mantle So Green, which I've also taught on my channel. So something nice about those two tunes, they are in the same key technically, but because you're going from this A minor, definite A minor feel, into the first note of Mantle So Green, you're starting on that C chord, and then you end up back in A minor again. So it's a decidedly different feel going from one into the other. Plus, Mantle So Green has a little more of a bouncy feel, and you could play it maybe even a little faster. Those are a couple of tunes especially, you could play them both faster or slower and they would sound good. So they have very different timing and a different feel, so there's contrast that way, even though they're technically in the same key. So to wrap up, to keep it really simple, you can play some tunes in the same keys, but you can try to find some other ways to contrast the tunes in either your style of accompaniment or the tune type or the speed of the tunes. And if you want to keep it simple while also changing keys, think of how many keys or modes you can get out of one lever setting, out of one key signature. Like if I'm in the key of G with one sharp, I can easily play in G as well as the relative minor E minor. I can also easily play in D Mixolydian with that lowered C, since I don't have C sharps up. I can do all three of those without changing any levers. Or if I'm in the key of D with two sharps, I can easily play in D, I can easily play in B minor, I can easily play in A Mixolydian, like we talked about those marches. I can easily play in E Dorian, that's another common key. With that C raised. And it won't be hard to find Celtic tunes in all of those keys. Those are very common keys. Most of all, don't be afraid to experiment. Try things out. See what sounds good together. There might be a couple of tunes that are easily in the same key or in an easily transitionable key, but they just don't sound good together. And you're not going to know unless you try it. If you'd like some help with making your own sets or with arranging or anything else, I do give once-off lessons on Zoom, so you can contact me at the info below and I'd love to set one up with you. I'm also going to be linking in my description box some other videos which are good examples of sets, so you can get some inspiration and some ideas that way. If you want to see more videos like this one about all kinds of different harp topics, you can click my Let's Talk Harp playlist right here, also linked in the description. And if you want to make sure you don't miss next week's video, click my face over here and make sure you click the bell so YouTube will notify you of the next video. You can also click this Patreon logo here for all kinds of different harp extras. And I'll see you next week. Bye!